In this example, we are given that a particle starts at initial speed of 17 meters per second, and it retards at 2 meters per second square. And we are required to find the distance covered by the particle in 9th second of motion. We just draw the physical situation in this question. We are having a particle, at t equals 0 it starts with an initial speed of 17 meters per second, and it is retarded with an opposite acceleration of 2 meter per second square. So gradually its speed will decrease. And after some time its final velocity will become 0. And we can easily calculate the time at which its final velocity is becoming 0. Say this time is t1, so we can simply write the equation v final equals u plus at. So here, 0 can be written as 17 minus 2t1 because acceleration will be minus in this case. So here we can see the time t1 we are getting is 17 by 2, that is 8.5 second. So at t1 equals 8.5 second it is coming to rest, and then it will return back because acceleration was opposite to this point. What will happen? Its velocity is retarded, it will come to rest and then it returns back due to the continuous action of acceleration, and now it will be in an accelerated motion. Now in this journey we are required to find the distance covered by the particle in 9th second of motion. We calculate the distance by using the formula of displacement of nth second, or displacement of particle in nth second. Just see what will happen. You will be able to have look on interesting result. The formula for nth second of motion was u plus a by 2 into 2n minus 1. So here we are required to analyze the motion in 9th second. So we find out the displacement in 9 second of motion. This will be 17 plus a by 2. This will be minus 2 by 2 into 2 into 9 minus 1. Just see what are you getting. This 17 minus this is 1, and this 18 minus 1 is 17. The result is 0. Now it is quite a surprising result how it is possible that displacement becomes 0. Yes, it is possible because you can see we are required to analyze the motion in 9th second. So 9th second will be the duration from t equals 8 to t equals 9 second of motion. This is the 9th second. So we can see at 8.5 second, the particle was at rest. It is the extreme position. So if it is at this position at t equals 8 second, it will take 0.5 second in going from this point to this point. And similarly, as we analyze the accelerated motion with same acceleration, it will take same time, that is 0.5 second in going from this point to this point back. So here it will reach at t equals 9 second. So you can see at t equals 8 and 9 second particle was at same position. That's why the result is coming out to be 0. This is the formula for displacement in 9 second. It is not given as the distance, and in the question it is asked to find the distance covered, so that we can easily calculate it by finding out the distance covered by the particle from rest within 0.5 second, and we make it twice. So, if this distance is s1, this s1 can be directly be written as half at square, as initial speed here is 0. So this half into 2 into 0.5 whole square. So this is 0.25 meter, so we can directly write distance covered in 9th second is this 2s1, that is equals 0.5 meter, which is the answer to the question. So be careful about such type of questions, which are slightly tricky. But several time it happened that students without any analysis, or without any thinking, they just apply the direct formulas, and they ignore such type of language in the question. So be careful in future about such type of questions.